Good afternoon, and thank you for attending the Fall Athletic Awards Ceremony. I'm grateful that we have the opportunity to recognize in person the accomplishments that you all have achieved this season. It doesn't seem like very long ago that the season itself was in question. Fast forward 3 months, and here we are having completed a very successful and safe fall season. This can be attributed to the flexibility and responsiveness of you and your coaches who stepped up to make a questionable season a reality. I am hopeful that we will continue to get these opportunities as the year goes on, but for now, I'm thankful that we are able to experience athletics and all the valuable lessons that come with them this year. Next, I would like to thank some people who helped make this season possible. I'll start by thanking Mr. Smith, our school superintendent, and the Board of Education for their support of athletics this season. In a year with so many variables, their support of athletics was necessary, as many schools across the state and country were unable to have a fall season. I would like to thank Mr. Bow for all of his work preparing our fields and keeping our grounds looking beautiful for practices and games. I'd like to thank Mrs. Spetzner and her staff in the bus garage for her work in getting our teams to practices and away games. This season brought about many last-minute changes in schedules, and she always made sure there is a driver available. I want to thank Mrs. Lang and Mrs. Trugel for their help in preparing this award ceremony. A special thanks to the sports boosters for their support, purchasing refreshments for tonight, as well as the customized neck gaiters that all athletes received this year. Finally, thank you to Maria Quintern, who every year volunteers to keep score at our home games and shows up rain or shine. If I missed anyone, I apologize. There are truly so many people who helped to make things work smoothly. Before I hand the program over to Coach Smith, I would like to take an opportunity to explain our award system. As you come up to the stage to receive your awards packet, you may find a variety of different certificates and pins. A letter, varsity or JV, is given to an athlete playing at that level for the first time. A letter certificate is given to any athlete who has played the sport at that level for the first time. For example, if you played varsity softball last year, but this is your first time playing varsity soccer, you will receive a certificate for that sport. Sport-specific pins are given out to varsity athletes who have played a varsity sport for the first time. First-time varsity soccer players will receive a soccer pin, and first year on varsity, and cross-country runners will receive a pin for their first year. If you have played a varsity or JV sport at the level for multiple years, you will receive a service bar that represents each additional year you have played that sport at that level. Scholar athlete pins are given to any varsity athlete who held a 90% or better average at the end of the first marking period. All-star pins are given to any athlete who is recognized as the Genesee Region League or Niagara Orleans team all-star. All athletes will receive a participation certificate for each season that they play a sport. Finally, coaches have the opportunity to choose up to 3 trophies or plaques to give out to their team for performance throughout the season. If you open your envelope and feel like you are missing any of these items, please stop down to see me and I will make sure I get it to you. Now I will turn the program over to Coach Smith for highlights of your season and the presentation of your awards. Thank you.
Good evening. I'm thankful that we were able to have a season this year and we were able to play 8 games. This season, we played games against Holly, Attica, Batavia, Medina, Albion, Roy Hart. And a couple of those we played twice. We finished this season 3-5, and we tripled the number of wins we had from last season. Last season we were 1-10. This year we were 3-5. We had wins against Holly, wins against Attica, and Albion. We lost to Attica a second time, Batavia, Medina, and Roy Hart. This season, we had several players score multiple goals and post multiple assists. Sebastian scored 7 goals, had 3 assists on the season. Mason Nicholson, 4 goals and 6 assists on the season. Josh Slingerland posted 2 assists on the season. And Trenton Luck scored a goal and had an assist on the season as well. So I'd like to go over some of the highlights that I have personally as a team. To start off the year, my objectives were, number one, that we wanted to win games this season, and we wanted to win with class and dignity, which we did do. Our first win over Holly this season, we posted four goals in about 45 minutes, after which point I told the players they were not allowed to shoot again unless they completed 15 passes in a row, and many of them responded, "We're never going to make that happen, Mr. Smith." But they did. They completed 15 passes in a row about 4 to 5 times. At one point, they even completed about 30 passes in a row, which was tremendous. Our second objective on the season, I wanted to grow a love of the game in the team, and I think that we were able to accomplish that every Friday before games, the day before a game on a Saturday. We would spend about half of practice time doing a team building exercise, which was a lot of fun. These were inspired actually by the athletes, so many of the ideas came from them. My only regret is funding the amount of candy that was consumed in every one of those team building exercises. That I definitely learned from that. But I believe that throughout the season that the boys developed a love of the game. We had several players on the team who don't normally play soccer historically. Trenton, Peyton, a few others. And it was a lot of fun watching them play. I've told Trenton a few times this season, I asked him if he was Brazilian a couple times, because on the ball he's so calm. So relaxed, four or five players around him all trying to steal the ball, and yet he's just sort of moving in slow motion. It was incredible. Peyton typically plays football. He played goalkeeper for us this season. He stopped 5 penalty shots. One of them he had to stop twice. The referee said he stepped off his line early, but nobody scored a penalty on Peyton this season, although there were a few 40-yarders. My third objective on the season, I wanted to develop the players and get them ready for the varsity level. We had 3 players that were invited up to varsity, Sebastian, Owen, and Mason. Mason actually played in a couple varsity games this season, especially he played in the postseason as well, I think, in the first round against Lackawanna. Great job, guys. Very proud of you there. Fourth, I wanted to build character for success in life through the game. And I think we did that. We learned some tough lessons this season. We had a tough loss against Medina at homecoming, followed by 3 yellow cards. And immediately after the game, we talked as a team about how important it is to have a good reputation. A good reputation is something that takes years to build, and you can tear it down quickly. A victory, you win in one day, and then you have to move on and try to win again. And I think that throughout this season, we were able to do that as a team, build character, learn some life lessons. I definitely enjoyed it. Objective number 5 was to have fun and have a successful season. I'm so thankful that we were able to have this season this year. In the light of everything going on with the pandemic, it's incredible that we were able to play all these games and do everything that we did. It's going to be a memorable one. We played some really cold games as well. We played a game, I think the wind chill, it was down, it felt like it was in the single digits. But we definitely enjoyed it this season. We were safe. I wanted to manage injuries this season very carefully. We did not have a large squad of players. Some of them played multiple sports at the same time. They'd come to soccer practice and immediately after they had football practice or some baseball practice or other practices. And I'm very proud to report we had no players miss games due to injury. Some missed a few minutes, but the players, they were safe. There were no major injuries this season. It's incredible. I also, last objective, wanted to make sure we could get everybody on the field, and everybody did play several minutes this year. We had 3 seventh graders on the team, and all of them played several minutes in every game to the best of my knowledge this season. And so, guys, I just want to say I'm proud of you and what you accomplished this season. Great job. I'm really looking forward to what the future holds. I know that several of you are looking to move up to varsity, and I want to encourage you to, even if you don't know if you might make it or not, I want to encourage you to try out. Put the work in the off-season over the summer on our Google Classroom. We do have, I have posted nutritional guides. I'm going to post workouts for you. And do everything you can. Try out for varsity next season. You guys make it, and really built that program. So thank you for playing this season. Everything here is because of you guys. And thank you so much for being a part of the program this season, making it possible, guys. Thank you. So I think I wish you could. So good job, guys. Team awards for the season. I'm going to call each player up one at a time. When you come up, please come up this set of stairs right here. Make your way across, collect your award from Mr. Z, and down on the far end, down the stairs, back to your seat. Okay? So we're going to start with Daniel Berry. Daniel Berry, come on down. Great job, Dan. All right, next up. Austin Fonda. Good job, Austin. Peyton Grabowski. Good job, Peyton. Justin Higgins. Good job, Justin. Ian Mank. Great job, guys. This season, we have three awards to pass out for the team, three big awards that you can put on your shelf, put on your office desk someday or something. I don't know. So there are some awards that I wish I could pass out, right, but I can't. Christian's not here tonight, but if we had a Best Mullet Award, I would definitely choose Christian for that one, right? I would say best goal of the season would be Trenton Muck's jumping volley against Attica off of a corner. Best tailgater of the season, that would go to Mr. Fonda and the hot dogs that he was passing out at the games. There's several things, but we have three awards this season. Those are defensive MVP, midfield MVP, and offensive MVP. We'll start with the defensive award first. This particular player was at times a one-man show on defense, rescued us on more than one occasion, was a constant presence at the back, strong, fast, can jump, authoritative. I love it. And I'm really excited about what the future holds for Owen Mank. Owen, come on up here. Our next award is the Midfield MVP Award. This player ran everywhere, helped us on defense at times, helped us on offense, scored goals, posted assists, was everywhere, did everything, got called up to varsity, played in two games for varsity, one of them in their postseason on their run to a co-championship in the section this year. That is Mason Nicholson. Mark. Our last major award for this season, that is the offensive MVP. This player had 7 goals and 3 assists on the season. His first year as a JV player, came up from modified. I talked to him, trying to convince him to go out for varsity next season. Whether he does or not, I sure hope he comes back and plays for me, maybe, if not varsity. But Sebastian, phenomenal season. Great job. Sebastian came in as a 9th grader, oftentimes was the only attacking player up front for us, the striker, the main man, the Harry Kane for us, if you will. As a 9th grader, Sebastian went and did battle with guys that were 11th graders on defense on the other team. He went up against 3 or 4 defenders and scored goals that I've never seen him score in practice before, outside of the foot, chip shot, top corner, crazy stuff, natural goal scorer. And great job, Sebastian. Great job to all of you guys on a great season. 3 wins this year. Next year, let's make it a lot more. All right? Thank you, Mr. Zeeler. Guys, that is going to conclude our program. The sports boosters did provide refreshments out in the lobby, so please help yourself to one of the snacks out there. And there's also water out there. You can help yourself to one of those as well. Before you leave, I need the 3 offensive MVP, midfield MVP, and the defensive MVP award winners to come up front. We're going to get your picture real quick to post in the hub tomorrow. All right, congratulations, guys. Thank you very much, and have a good night.